Hello students, I'm Dr. Seema Singh and you're watching my channel Bonding with Chemistry. In today's video, I'll continue with the topic some important chemicals that can be obtained from common salt. In my next video, I'll wind up this chapter by taking a small but significant topic which is water of crystallization. So stay tuned to my channel by hitting the bell icon for latest updates and please subscribe to it in case you haven't. You can go through the various topics of this chapter that I've covered in my previous videos by clicking the link provided in the description box below. In my previous video, I took up two chemical compounds, namely sodium hydroxide and bleaching powder. In this video, I'll take up the remaining two that are baking soda and washing soda. Both these compounds are very important from examination point of view as there can be a direct as well as reasoning question or so-called HOTS question from here. Let us begin with baking soda. As the name suggests, this salt finds use in baking as a leavening agent or raising agent. For those who are not aware, baking is a method of preparing food items such as breads, cakes, pastries, cookies that uses dry heat, normally in an oven or microwave. Heat is gradually transferred from the surface of food to the center. As the heat travels, the food gets baked with a firm dry crust, that is the upper layer, and a softer center. As baking soda causes the baked item to rise, making them soft and fluffy, it acts as a leavening agent. You probably must have seen your mother adding a pinch of baking soda while preparing crispy and tasty fritters, called pakoras in Hindi. Also, it is added to soften pulses such as peas, kidney beans before and during cooking to reduce cooking time. The main effect of baking soda is to modify the pH of the soaking water as well as cooking water, which in turn softens the hard external shells of peas, kidney beans, etc. This eventually makes cooking faster. Now, all this information was provided to you to enhance your basic knowledge. The chemical name of baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate, also known as sodium bicarbonate. It also goes by the name of soda bicarb, cooking soda, as well as bread soda. The chemical formula being NaHCO3. Coming on to its preparation, it is prepared in laboratory from sodium chloride by passing carbon dioxide gas through a cold solution of sodium chloride saturated with ammonia. The equation for the reaction illustrate that the products are sodium hydrogen carbonate and ammonium chloride. Moving on to some of the properties of baking soda, you may be able to recall from your knowledge about pH that baking soda is alkaline or basic in nature with a pH greater than 7. In fact, you can also predict the nature of this salt by identifying the corresponding acid and base with which it is formed. I've already explained this part in my video on salts, whose link is provided on top. So the corresponding acid and base for sodium hydrogen carbonate are, you're going to add H here and OH here. So the acid is H2CO3, carbonic acid, and the corresponding base is sodium hydroxide. Now since the base is strong, whereas the acid weak, your sodium hydrogen carbonate is a basic salt. Being a base, it is bitter in taste. Since it is a mild, non-corrosive base, by non-corrosive I mean doesn't produce or cause burn injury on coming in contact with skin, it finds use as an antacid to neutralize excess acid. Let us learn the action of heat on sodium bicarbonate. Now this reaction is quite important from examination point of view. When sodium hydrogen carbonate is heated, it gives rise to sodium carbonate as well as carbon dioxide and water. This reaction explains its role in cooking and we'll learn about it in a short while. Let us have a look at the uses of sodium bicarbonate. Students, please note that this part is also useful because you can have a variety of questions framed from here. Sodium bicarbonate is used extensively in the making of baking powder. Yes, baking soda is different from baking powder and many a time students get confused between the two. Don't worry, shortly I'll tell you a trick to differentiate the two. Baking powder is a mixture of baking soda and a mild edible acid such as tartaric acid or citric acid. Remember, you have learned in the introductory video that tamarind, Imli in Hindi, consists of tartaric acid, whereas citrus fruits like oranges contain citric acid. Both these acids are fit to be consumed or eaten and hence are said to be edible. This baking powder is mixed with the dough or batter for preparing cakes, breads and cookies. When this dough or batter is heated, the following reaction takes place. Let us understand the role of baking soda and mild edible acid in baking powder and hence in this reaction. As already explained a little while ago, sodium hydrogen carbonate, that is NaHCO3, in presence of heat give rise to sodium carbonate, a base, plus carbon dioxide gas is evolved and water is produced. Let me balance this. Okay, so you can see that in this reaction, CO2 and water comes from baking soda. We'll come back to what happens to sodium carbonate in a while after discussing the role of carbon dioxide. The bubbles of carbon dioxide gas while escaping leave behind pores which causes the bread and cakes to rise, thus increasing their size and making them light and fluffy. In other words, when CO2 gas is evolved, it is absorbed by the product cells. Now by product I mean cakes or any other baked item. As the gas expands, so does the product cells, thus leavening the product. I have already explained you what leavening means. The tartaric acid or any other edible acid. Now here, since acid gives H plus ion, so instead of showing the complicated formula of tartaric acid, we have written here H plus. So this H plus is going to come from acid. Now this acid is going to neutralize this base. If in case this neutralization is not done, then due to the presence of sodium carbonate, the cake or the baked product would taste bitter, having soapy or metallic taste. Hence, when you heat baking powder, you get carbon dioxide, water and sodium salt of acid. This sodium salt of acid comes from the neutralization reaction of tartaric acid or any mild edible acid with sodium carbonate. Thus, dear learner, remember, baking powder must be added during the preparation of cakes, pastries, etc. In its absence, cake or any other baked product formed would be comparatively small and hard. Because of the reasons that I just explained, baking soda when used alone, that means you're not using baking powder, this acid part is missing. Then that baking soda is combined with acidic substances such as lemon juice, curd, buttermilk or vinegar to prepare the dough or the batter, as these acidic substances would induce this reaction and not impart bitter taste to the prepared food item. For instance, while preparing chickpeas fried leavened flat bread recipe. Oh, such a complicated recipe. Well, this is nothing but our favorite Indian chole bhature recipe. Generally, curd or buttermilk is added along with baking soda for kneading the dough so that the bhaturas are fluffy and soft. Students, did a thought ever cross your mind that although baking powder consists of an acid and a base sealed in the same bottle, yet they do not react? This is because baking powder, in addition to baking soda and mild edible acid, consists of an inert stabilizer. Well, it is a term used for an inactive ingredient that prevents the mixture from reacting with each other. Generally, a small amount of corned starch is used. Everything stays inert or intact or does not react in the mixture until liquid such as water is added. Once it is added, this reaction takes place. Dear learners, if you are still not sure whether or not you will remember the difference between baking soda and baking powder, here's a simple trick. Look, the word baking is common to both baking powder and baking soda. So simply remember the first alphabet of the second word. So this is the first alphabet of the second word. S means soda and S implies single ingredient. It is simply single. It is not combined with anything else. Whereas the first alphabet of the second word in baking powder is P. P implies plenty. That means two or three ingredients are added or plenty of ingredients are added into it. I hope this helps. Even if remember one of them, you'll be able to recall the other one correctly. Baking soda also finds use as a common antacid to treat acid indigestion and heartburn. We've already studied about this in previous videos. It reacts with stomach acid to produce salt, water, and carbon dioxide. Sodium hydrogen carbonate also find use in soda acid fire extinguisher. For further details, you can always go through the link provided on top where I've already explained this type of extinguisher. Let us take up few NCERT questions to test our understanding of the compound baking soda. The first being, what will happen if a solution of sodium hydrogen carbonate is heated? Give the equation of the reaction involved. So here's the answer. Coming to the next question, a milkman adds a very small amount of baking soda to fresh milk. Why does he shift the pH of the fresh milk from 6 to slightly alkaline? Why does this milk take a long time to set as curd? Before I answer this question, let me take up the next one. Fresh milk has a pH of 6. How do you think the pH will change as it turns into curd? Explain your answer. From your previous knowledge, I'm sure you remember that curd contains lactic acid. As milk would turn into curd, more of this acid would be produced and hence the pH would decrease. Now it will be easy to answer the previous question. Just remember, as the pH of milk would decrease, it would start curdling. The milkman shifts the pH from 6 to slightly alkaline by adding baking soda to fresh milk so that the curdling of milk is delayed. Baking soda being a base would neutralize the effect of lactic acid present in the milk and hence would check or prevent the milk from getting sour readily. This milk, being alkaline in nature, tends to take longer time to set as curd, as the bacteria is going to be lactobacillus. It will take longer time to produce lactic acid, which is responsible for decreasing the pH and initiating the curd formation. Moving on to the next chemical that can be obtained from common salt, that is washing soda, a compound that has been known since very early times and is primarily used for washing clothes and hence gets its name. Chemically, washing soda is known as sodium carbonate decahydrate. Here deca means 10. It has the formula Na2CO3.10H2O. So here this 10H2O, this deca means 10 molecules of water. This 10H2O implies water of crystallization. We'll study more about it in my next video. In anhydrous state, that is without these water molecules, it has the formula Na2CO3 and is known as soda ash, as historically or in the past, it was extracted from ashes of plant growing in sodium-rich soils. Washing soda is manufactured using sodium chloride as the raw material. The various steps involved in its preparation are as follows. You are familiar with the first two reactions. This one is the preparation of sodium hydrogen carbonate, and the second one is the action of heat on soda bicarb to give sodium carbonate, that is soda ash. Thereafter, this anhydrous sodium carbonate is recrystallized from water, giving rise to washing soda. The process of obtaining sodium carbonate is known as the Solvay process or ammonia soda process. Coming on to the properties of washing soda, it is a white solid, soluble in water, basic or alkaline in nature with pH greater than 7. Here too, you can predict the nature of the salt by identifying the corresponding acid and base with which it is formed. Just like sodium bicarbonate, washing soda is also made up of strong base sodium hydroxide and weak acid, that is carbonic acid, and hence it is basic or alkaline in nature with bitter taste. Let us learn some of the uses of washing soda. It is among one of the most useful chemicals in industry. It is used in the manufacture of many important and useful compounds such as glass, soap, paper, sodium hydroxide, detergents, etc. It is also used in the manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax, about which you will study in higher classes. Washing soda, justifying its name, is used for washing purposes in laundry and as cleaning agent for household purposes. It is used for softening hard water, that is removing permanent hardness of water. We will study more about types of hardness and the removal in Unit 4, under the topic soaps and detergents. I'm sure you'll now be able to answer this simple NCERT question correctly. Name the chemical compound which is used in softening hard water. The answer is washing soda or sodium carbonate decahydrate. Dear learners, I would summarize this video by providing you few questions from NCERT textbook, CBSE sample papers as well as NCERT exemplar. Students, I would suggest that you test your knowledge by pausing the video and taking up these questions as a small 5 to 7 minutes test. In case you get stuck up, you can always go back to the content of the video. Let me provide answer to one of the question. Let us say this one. For making cake, baking powder is taken. That's true. If at home your mother uses baking soda instead of baking powder in cake, how will it affect the taste of the cake and why? Now, if your mother uses baking soda, S means single ingredient. It only consists of sodium hydrogen carbonate. Then what will happen? The cake would taste bitter. And why would it taste bitter? Due to the formation of sodium carbonate. Let's look at part B. How can baking soda be converted into baking powder? Now, baking powder means plenty of ingredient. So you can convert baking soda into baking powder by addition of a mild edible acid such as tartaric acid or citric acid. What is the role of tartaric acid added to baking soda? Tartaric acid present in baking powder would neutralize the base sodium carbonate. If in case this neutralization is not done, then due to the presence of sodium carbonate, the cake would taste bitter, having soapy or metallic taste. With this, I come to the end of this video. If you liked my video, do please give it a thumbs up. In my next video, I'll wind up chapter 2 with the topic water of crystallization, where you also will learn about plaster of Paris and gypsum. So stay tuned to my channel, please subscribe to it, and above all, if you feel this video can help any learner perform better, kindly share. Thanks for watching, and until next time, stay bonded, my dear learners.